quick story while we are waiting for this light to turn green. So check this out. So the other day, I was watching some random YouTube video about a motorcycle vlogger. If you guys have ever seen those motorcycle guys, they have like the walkie-talkies that record audio and video with their GoPros, and then they just kind of like pretty much do vlogging on their motorcycles. Well, anyway, this one guy, I'm like, huh, that looks a little interesting. He's like driving up and down the street with his buddy, and I'm like, that kind of looks familiar. I'm like, oh, hey, that's like right by my house. That's the shopping center. Anyway, guys, it was kind of funny because I kind of recognized it, and I was like, nah, nah, no way, no way. And then he starts rolling down the street, and I'm like, wait a second. Anyway, he's a fairly big YouTuber that does the motorcycle vlogs. I don't know the name of the channel. Again, I just kind of stumbled upon his channel because he had a picture of a cop pulling somebody over, and I thought they were getting pulled over, but they were pulling over another driver that cut double yellows. That, my friends, is called kind of clickbait, when what the video is describing doesn't really reveal the picture somewhat, but sometimes not. Anyway, who? First stop, guys, Wells Fargo. We need to withdraw some money because Daddy needs to pay this car payment. Well, my friends, we got the monies. We got the monies, my friends. And you're like, Chris, man, that's a lot of money. Well, yes, it is. You would be correct in saying that, but it doesn't belong to me. It belongs to the bank. You know why? Because I still have a car payment. Car is almost paid off. I have about $1,600 to go until this car is paid off. Not $16,000, $1,600. And so let me tell you a brief story if you guys are ever thinking about buying a luxury automobile. All right, number one, if you guys are thinking about buying a high-end luxury automobile like a Lexus, Mercedes-Benz, BMW, Audi, especially. All right, we got some, definitely some nice boxes, some bubble tape back there. See, I always tie it in, guys, with doing a little dumpster diving too. Back to the story. Mostly with German automobiles, okay? This right here, guys, is a BMW. I was definitely blessed to receive it, but this is a blessing in disguise. We had to put on that seatbelt, even though we're in a parking lot. So, brief story. My Cadillac, before I had this, again, I was a full-time chauffeur driver, just like Uber, but for my own company. My Cadillac was stolen. It was stolen, and I went through, oh my goodness gracious, when you are a commercial vehicle, and your livelihood depends on your car. Number one, it's a bad business. You know why? Because it's an expensive business. Because if your car breaks down and that's what you do for a living, okay, it's not like a normal job where you can just like, you know, get an Uber to your work, you know, pay an Uber X like, you know, 15 bucks and get over to your job. And yeah, you gotta take a little bit of a hit, but you know what I'm saying? Well, no, this is my livelihood. This is my bread and butter. If my car is broken down, I don't make any money. Plus, I have clients that depend on me that are already scheduled in books. It just, it wasn't a good business plan. The Lord protected me though, and he kept me going through it all, which is awesome. But that was a whole experience. So Cadillac, now the BMW. So I picked this up pre-owned, and you're gonna save thousands. I'm talking thousands. Within the first 2-3 years, the value of a Mercedes-Benz and BMW and Audi drops through the roof. Okay, Lexus is, of course, a Japanese car maker, same as Toyota. That retains its value better than the European cars. European cars, guys, I'm telling you, look on autotrader.com and just research a 3-year-old BMW 3 Series compared to what it costs brand new, and it plummets. I'm talking plummets, guys. So if you want to drive a nice high-end car and buy it for cheap, buy a used luxury vehicle. You can do CarMax, certified pre-owned and all that stuff. I'm pretty good with car maintenance. So literally, I didn't even pop the hood of this car. I just picked it up because, again, I needed a car fast. I rented a car for like a week and a half, and insurance, even though my car got stolen, insurance did not pay for that rental car. That was on my own dime. And even though your car gets stolen, you gotta pay your deductible. Ay, ay, ay. So they cashed me out, they paid for my value of my car minus a $1,000 deductible. Even though my car got stolen, I was like, ay, 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 this is a learning experience, guys. So, anywho, with regular insurance, though, they'll pay for your rental car, but with commercial, they didn't pay for my rental car, and they even charged me a tow charge to tow it from the accident site, because it was recovered, but the guy got in a police chase. I'll tell you that full story another time. Well, you know, we could just tell it to you right now. Anywho, make a long story short, the kid was a young kid. He stole my car. He had it for about a day and a half. A off-duty police officer saw him, radioed it in, followed him. All of a sudden, more cars in pursuit, lit him up, he didn't stop. He then got in a high-speed chase in a residential neighborhood, okay? Not good for business, my friends. He winds up pulling into a cul-de-sac, right? Pulls into a cul-de-sac, and literally, once he realizes he's in a cul-de-sac, throws it in reverse, probably doing very high speed in reverse, probably at least 40, 45 miles an hour, as the police officers are coming around the corner. Okay, he rear ends a police officer's car. All right, puts him in the hospital. My car is like an accordion, breaks the actual seat, And he then, without being injured, he pops it back in drive, runs it into the side of a house, jumps out, flees on foot. Helicopters come out all over the news. My friends I was golfing with are like, dude. They're like, I was watching the news and they were talking about this police chase and blah, 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 blah. That was your car? Oh my gosh. Anyway, guys, he was caught, put in jail. They sentenced him to like a year and a half of jail. Guess what? He was out in like maybe a week over a month. Are you joking me right now? And I asked the lady, I said, why is he out of jail already? And you know what their response was? He is not a high risk offender or something like that. What does that mean? You put an officer in the hospital, you fled on foot, you almost got vehicular manslaughter, and that's not a high-risk crime? And the kid was only in jail for like 4.5 weeks, and he was supposed to be sentenced to a year and a half? Aye, my friends. The system is broken, but you know who can fix it? Jesus, my friends. Jesus can fix the system, my friends. That's my only hope. My only hope these days, my friends. So, nice long story for you as we drive to the post office right now. We're gonna drop off eBay auctions. Let's go ahead and lighten the mood a little bit. We put a little change in our pocket. We're then gonna go pay my car payment. Then we are gonna go back to Goodwill or vice versa. And then we got some action in the books for today.
Hey, look at that, a couch next to Goodwill. That's what I'm talking about. Pick it up. Let's see what we got here today, my friends, for Goodwill. Oh man, I actually don't have too much. I got this computer system thingamabobber over here. I got these books I gotta look up to see what the value is. We got a battery, but can't do that. Obviously, you gotta recycle that, recycle oil. That is gonna be mine. That's a projector slide. So let's go ahead and get rid of this guy here. We'll just get this guy out of the way. Creative computer sound system there.
Well, I just realized the store I gotta go to is right here. For my car payment inside Albertsons, and Goodwill is literally right behind us, right over there. So that's what you call a lazy guy forgetting. I should have just walked over, because now I just moved my car about 30 feet. I'm always one of these guys that parks far away from everyone else, like in the very, very deep part of the parking lot. You know how you see those random cars in the very, like, way into the parking lot? Like if you're at the gym, what mind boggles me is that, check this out, right? So people go to the gym to work out, right? And you know, they want to exercise, they get on the treadmill like right away, they get on the elliptical or whatever, but they circle for like 5 minutes trying to find a parking spot like right there. So I don't really understand that. I gotta film this quick, guys, but look at this, house for sale with a big dumpster. Keep your eye on that. Obviously, probably a remodel, but you never know. They could be hucking some good stuff, especially if some of these folks are cleaning out their garages. Some people are just not garage type people. So if they want more room for something else, they'll actually tear down some of their really awesome garage organization items. So definitely we will be keeping our eye on the prize. You know what I'm saying? That's what I always do, guys. Always keep your eye on the prize. I take the long way home just because it's, you know, something else to look at. You never know, especially because right now I just drove by right where we saw those dumpsters. That one that was actually for sale, probably if it sold for almost $1 million, probably low nines, maybe a mil, because it is up there more towards upwards of you. Could even pop for 1.1, don't know. But again, that's literally up the street from our condominium, and it's like crossing over the railroad tracks. It's like, you know, condos over here and million-dollar homes over here. It's crazy. I love the neighborhood, though. I love the neighborhood. God's definitely blessed us, so I have no complaints. It's something to work hard for. Hopefully, you never know. You work hard enough, you find enough things dumpster diving and resell them, you might be able to move up the hill.
All right there, baby. Look at that right there. We're looking absolutely fantastic, guys. These are the extra hooks that we grabbed last night. So again, we're gonna go ahead and put them all up there, do all kinds of good stuff here. Again, we still have this small slat wall right there, this one right here. And then we have the aluminum one, and then we have two metal ones right here. So we got a lot of slat walls, a lot of hooks. We're good to go for pretty much the rest of our lives right here, baby. Well, my friends, it happened again. This is, my friends, one day worth. Wow, goodness gracious. But one of them I actually did order myself, actually paid for this one right here. Reason being is, let me demonstrate why. This, my friends, is my iPhone. As we can see there, I dropped it and it is shattered. And it still functions, still works, but it gets a little scraggly through here. And not to mention when scrolling, you don't want to scroll over chipped glass, as we can see there. So I've ordered a new LCD and new digitizer, home button, everything, front pole, front assembly. And I'm gonna show you guys in the vlog, and I will have a full video, but I'll give you a little preview of it. That is the easiest way to fix your iPhone glass, is just order the whole front assembly with the home button, front camera already attached, literally unscrew, suction cup it off. I'm gonna also replace the battery, so I have to wait for the battery to come over the weekend. I'm gonna replace the battery and the full screen. And then what I'm actually gonna do, guys, is actually I'm gonna sell this glass right here. Now you're wondering, who in the world is gonna buy the glass that's already broken? Trust me, it's OEM Apple, which means people will pay for it, which means that this home button is OEM Apple, front camera, and the LCD is still good. So someone that wants to spend the time to repair the glass with UV glue, all that stuff, and actually get it for a cheap, cheap price. One time I actually sold a front assembly OEM Apple. Actually, I shouldn't say OEM, I should say genuine Apple front assembly. After I purchased a new one, I sold it for good dollars. It actually, then a new one only cost me about half price. So I resold it on eBay because, again, the LCD is still good. It's just the cracked glass. So a professional will remove the glass, use the LCD, the home button, the front camera, skip the glass, put new glass on, UV glue underneath, et cetera, et cetera. I just don't have time for all that mumbo jumbo. And then we're gonna get a new iPhone, new glass on the iPhone, I should say.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. is gonna be home any minute. Well, not any minute, but in about 15 minutes. So we're gonna go through this very quickly, because I realize the vlog is probably going to be pretty long, so I don't want it to be too long. We've already talked about this. We're going to get into that probably in the next couple days. All right, first one. Very nice, guys. 3-in-1 cell phone holder for your car. Very cool. Number two, very nice, guys. A 2-in-1 splitter for your hose. 2-in-1 into one. Very nice. Number three, big, big one. Number three, D-Light, a architect style light, very cool. And number four, I think I already know what this one is, and I'm actually pretty excited about this one. Very nice, guys. Boom, the brand new T18 gaming headphones. Oh yes, oh yes, these are sick, guys. All right, let's do some other stuff before Mrs. gets home.
My friends, this is what happens after an hour of class. Look at that sweat right there. I'm sorry about that. Hopefully that will get cleaned up. Look, it's a garage sale. It's just my gloves are everywhere. Woo! Here we go. She's still going. She's still going. She's thinking about work. She's like, TPS reports? Forget those TPS reports. Let's just get jacked and tan and cut. Boom, summertime, baby. Summertime, what you got? Boom, boom, boom. 3-2, 3-2, 3-2. All right, guys, you see that blue bag right there? It's looking at me funny. Let's kick it right up top. Try not to hook my thing. Let's see how high we can get. All right, here we go. Pump my Jordans up. My Jordans are pumped up. Let's go. Woo! Yeah! Woo! That was at least 10 foot. I can slam dunk 10 foot right there. I'm 5'8 on a good day.
Well, folks, after a hard workout comes hard nutrition. Acai bowl, fresh fruits, a little bit of granola down there. It's a little sweet.
Thank you.
sell tires in a supermarket and we sell scooters in a supermarket. This is not your typical Costco. This is literally like a grocery store that sells mopeds inside the grocery store. This is what I'm talking about.